And we're back. Welcome to part two of the DriveWorksXpress tutorial on how to drive an assembly. So where we left off in part one was creating this form. I'm just going to continue right on through here and create some additional fields in this form. We're going to have box width. We're going to add another one here. This is going to be box depth. Add another one here, box height. Okay, does the box have a shell feature? Okay, this time what we'll do is we'll make this a checkbox option, so you can just check yes or no, or just hit a check mark there. Something I talked about in the last example when I was generating the part file. Okay, box shell thickness. Maybe this time we'll say this can only be within a range. The thickness can be 5, it can be 10, it can be 15, it can be 20, or it can be 25. Those are the only available thicknesses. Okay, let's add another field here. Does the box have a hole? Box have a hole feature. And this will be another checkbox option. We're going to add another field here. What's the hole diameter? Box hole diameter. We'll add another question. This one's going to be, does the box include a lid? So we can show an example of how to drive file names and whether or not files even exist. So this time, instead of making a text box, I'm going to make it a drop down, and I'm going to say yes, no. Make it a little more clear as to, you know, sometimes when it's a check mark, you might be wondering, do I check yes if I want it, or, you know, do I hit the check mark if I want it or if I don't want it? Be a little confusing. When it's yes, no, it's very clear. We'll add one here for the, do we need lid depth and lid width? No, because those items are going to be driven directly by the box depth and the box width. But we do need a lid thickness field. Okay, and that lid thickness, I'm just going to make the rest of these text boxes for the sake of time. Does the lid have a handle? Okay, and I'll make this a yes, no again. And what's the handle height? And this will just be, again, a text box. Now, there's a lot of cool things that you can do with the rules for these boxes, but again, for the sake of time, I'm just going to keep this one pretty simple, and you can look at my previous tutorial to see what some of those rules are, some of the options you can set up. But this is basically how our form's looking, and you can see here that anything that's got this red field is a required field. So for my project number, I'll just call it 12345. For the box width, I'll go with these standards, 200. The box height, or depth, I mean, is going to be 100. The box height, I'll make that 75. Does the box have a shell feature? Yes. What's the shell thickness? 10. Does the box have a hole feature? Yes. What's the hole diameter? 35. Does the box include a lid? Yes. What's the lid thickness? 15. Does the lid have a handle? Yes. What is the lid handle height? 30. I'm going to set these as the defaults, and what that's going to do for me is it's going to set me up so that I can utilize those numbers when I'm testing my form. So now I need to create some rules for my form. So first I'm going to edit the file name rules, okay? And this first file name, DW Assembly, I'm just going to have that based on the project number. So I'll go in here to project number and click next. And the way that I'm accessing these is I'm double clicking. Same thing with DWE box, double click, input is going to be the project number. Whatever project number I put in this case 12345, it's going to append DWE box with 12-12345. The lid is going to be a little bit more tricky. With a lid, I'm going to create an if-then statement, okay? And there's an example of an if-then statement elsewhere in the software, but just to kind of spell this one out, I'm going to use some logic here, and I'm going to say if, and then the input is going to be if does box include a lid equals, so this is going to be some more logic here, equals exactly the word yes, Y-E-S, in quotations, then unsuppress. I'm sorry, then use the input project number. Otherwise, I'm going to put in quotations here, delete. In other words, if does box include a lid equals no, then delete the file called lid. So I'm going to go next here, and that's going to finish me up for those rules. Now I need to edit the rules dealing with the dimensions. This is going to take a little bit more time. So box width, the input for that is going to be box width. Next. What else is going to use the input for box width? Lid width. I want that to be the same value. So the input for lid width is going to be box width. Box depth, the input for that will be box depth. What else will be the input, will be driven by the input for box depth? Lid depth. So these are the dimensions that I had created earlier that I'm now linking to. So box depth is also going to be linking to lid depth. Box height, what's the input for that going to be? It's going to be box height, just like you would imagine. Wall thickness, the input for that is going to be box shell thickness. Okay, now hole height from base. I'm going to make this a logical statement as well, an if-then statement. So this is going to be a logic statement. It's going to be if the input for box height is less than or equal to 80, then the hole height from the base is going to be 35. Otherwise, the hole height from the base is going to be 50. Okay, so just a little logic statement there to drive that location. Hole diameter, that'll be the input for box hole diameter. Lid thickness, that'll be the input for lid thickness. Lid handle thickness, I want that to be the same, so that's also going to be the input for lid thickness. Lid handle height, the input for that is going to be, as you could imagine, lid handle height. And lastly here, lid handle offset from end. Okay, the input for that is going to be another if-then statement. So with that one, I'm going to say logic if input is going to be if box width is less than or equal to 150, then the offset from the end is going to be 30. Otherwise, the offset from the end is going to be 50. Okay, so it's going to be based on the box width. Little logical rules there we're programming in. Lastly, we need to program in some rules for our features. So with our feature, our shell, the shell is going to utilize another if-then statement. This time it's going to be if, I'm just copy clipping from down here, if something equals true, then unsuppress, otherwise delete. The something is not going to be chamfer required. The something is going to be does box have a shell feature. If does box have the shell feature equals true, meaning checked, then unsuppress the shell feature. Otherwise, delete the shell feature. So some nice if-then statements are down here in the samples when you're in features. And you can just take this and select it, press Control-C for copy, paste it up here, and then modify the rule based on your own inputs. So with the feature hole, it's going to be the same thing. Okay, if, go to this inputs here, if the does box have a hole feature is checked on or true, then unsuppress the hole feature, otherwise delete the hole feature from that model. That's something I went over in detail in the previous webinar. So you can take a look at the previous YouTube video to get some more information on that. Lastly, the feature handle. This is going to be similar, but this time it's going to be using yes, no. So this time it's going to say if does lid have a handle equals, and instead of true here, it's going to be yes, equals quote yes, then unsuppress, otherwise delete. Now, I want you just to see here in the last minute of this video, I want you to see what happens down here where it says result. That result is based on the defaults that I've programmed in. So as soon as I type YES and then put a final quotation mark on there, it tells me the result is going to be unsuppressed. And that's important because it allows you to test some of your rules. Let's take a look at some of the other rules that we've gone over here. So instead of only showing missing rules, what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to show all the rules. Let me just go to next here. Show all the rules or edit all rules and go next. And now I'm going to take a look at another one where I created an if-then statement. So here's another one, if box height. So here what I'm saying is hole height from base. If the box height equals less than or equal to 80, then make that offset 35, otherwise make it 50. And right now, the value that's returning is 35. And what is that being based on? It's being based on this test here that I created on the form. Okay, box height is 75. So we'll take a quick break here, and we'll come back with part 3 of this webinar.